Hey everyone, Tyler here. I have a friend, his name's Avila, Chris Avila, and he's going to be doing a deck profile. What's the deck called?
It's Inzektor-Wind-Ups.
Inzektor-Wind-Ups. So, pretty unique build. Anyways, let's get started. Are you ready, man?
Yeah.
Show that shit.
Alright. Start off with the Inzektor engine. Play three Hornets. This basic, the basic engine, the original engine. It's three Dragonflies and three Centipedes and a Gigamantis. Not much more. Not the new stuff. This is still different. I'm trying to test it out. I have both Inzektors and Wind-Ups made. I just wanted to combine them. Alright, that's the Inzektor.
It's not a bad build.
Real small. Wind-Ups. Gotta play three Sharks. Three Rat. A Hunter. Two Magicians. No Rabbits. It's not really a wind-up deck, so you don't necessarily need Rabbit. You're basically just using this for the loop. And the deck's main point is to destroy and then cross over into the loop. So, like, if I went second, I would go off with the Dragonfly, clip the Hornet, plop, switch on the Centipede. Then exceed for Zen Mighty, and then go into the wind-up loop after.
Pretty good.
Just a basic tour guide engine. Three tour guide. A tour bus. It's a nice level 3, and it helps you get into the loop a little faster. It helps you loop more, actually. It's the fourth, it gets the fourth card. In the same game. So that doesn't make the tour guides dead. This one Armageddon Knight to get that Hunter or the Hornet in the graveyard and a Genex Lightbird Man. It's a level 3. You can bounce your Dragonfly back and go into some synchros like Underground Arachnid, Mistworm even. Maybe like there's synchros in here. It's not a big synchro deck, but it's just like there. It's pretty good. Not only that, it's a level 3. Helps you send that Dragonfly back so you can reuse it next turn. If you have a normal summon, just bounce it back. Just blow up some more cards. Alright, that's it for the monsters. Not that many. It's like 24, maybe. Spells. One Factory. Two Instant Fusion. And Avarice. And Foolish. For the same reason that Armageddon Knight. You like the Hunter and the Graveyard more in this deck than you do in regular wind-ups. I don't know why, it's just, it helps you. The main point of this is to loop and destroy. It's not, like, wind-ups. It's just a base of both. It's not really super-duper competitive. But it's still pretty broken when it gets its combos off. Just, this is a staple of spells. I only play three traps. Call of Haunteds and a Solemn. It's not much to this deck, just to destroy, then loop. This deck has a lot of side-heavy problems like skill drain, the chain disappearances. They all hurt. That's why I prefer to play the regular Inzektors and the regular wind-ups. But I want to see what you guys think about it. How you guys think this deck fares at all? It's not really seen in any topping at all. I'm not sure why. I mean, it's probably because of those sides I said. But all in all, it's just a fun deck. I made a while back, and now it's finally complete.
You want to show the extra deck, too.
Oh, yeah, the extra deck's relatively simple. Just three Zen Mighties and a Zen Mains. And you got Leviathan Dragon, Ten Tempo. I like Ten Tempo more than Musa Rhythm because it detaches an XC, then he gains 500. It's pretty good. Giga Brilliant. Levier for that bottomless of your Hunter. E1 Utopia, Armory Arm, this one's supposed to be in here because there's no Veiler. Just the Underground Arachnid, Black Rose, Stardust, and a Mistworm. A Monster Born from their graveyard, sorry about that. Really put them in the middle here for you. And I like Underground Arachnid. It lets you get it out with a Bird Math, that's the only way to get it out. And an Inzektor. And you just equip their monster. You don't do anything with their monster. It just gets over like Stardust and Zen mains, you just equip it to them. And equip it to him, now you get over the new problem. He's got 24. It's like an ancient gear. I don't know, I like the deck, so YouTube, tell me what you think. Post whatever you want on Tyler's channel.
Yeah, any tips are appreciated. It's a pretty unique build. Not exactly main meta build, but, you know, it could be improved, most likely. So, you know, post a comment and let us know what you think, what you would change in it to make it more competitive for the current meta.
Yeah, I have a different wind-up build, too. It's really unique. It's not anything... It's not net decked fully. It's not even net decked. It's like five extra wind-up monsters that I play. See what you guys think about that. It's been pretty consistent. I like it more than those wind-ups that everyone else uses. So tell post and comment what you, if you want to see that. It's pretty fun. It is unique, though. Probably people won't like it because it is so different.
Yeah, we could do that, too, in the future. But anyways, everybody, thanks for watching the video. We hope you enjoyed the deck profile. I know I don't have a lot of these on my channel, so that's exactly why we're doing this. But just post a comment and let us know what you think and what you'd improve and whatnot. And thanks for watching. See ya.